Okay. And code
is 3689.
Okay.
Sweet.
We in.
We
okay.
We
I know
can even
two things that we can do. Let's check the prop room. Just in case we missed something here. Which I honestly think we did, because I vaguely kind of remember it, there being a puzzle in here that we didn't do. In fact, I know exactly what it is. Where is it? Where is the puzzle? Where is the puzzle? Lillian, where is it?
Which puzzle?
The disc one where you have to move it from one side to the other.
Oh, it's like in a chest, isn't it?
Yeah, well, this
is that chest?
It's locked.
Is it?
Maybe I can just open it. I think I walked up to it and thought it was locked last time.
There it is.
This one. This puzzle takes some time, but other than that, it's super easy. That way. Okay. And there's that. Okay. I knew it was around somewhere. I think that's the only thing we're missing at this point, right?
Yeah, I think you're right.
Okay, so we know how to do that now. We have access to this. We probably could access Lillian's office too, maybe.
I need something to make this
the
work.
Same thing. Yep. Just Jimmy the lock. Is this the only game in the series where we do that? I feel like it is.
With the card?
Yeah.
No. I think we do it in Warnings from Waverly Academy.
That could be.
I vaguely remember jimmying locks with the card.
Yeah.
We find like a student ID.
Aggression. New threat. Menace. Monster. Jeez. Lillian, are you okay? Oh.
3D glasses?
Oh, this is that stupid thing.
Oh, no. I'm gonna
We don't even know what the password is yet, though.
But we're gonna need this.
Yeah, it's true. Can you even read it? No, it looks like it's fine on the photo.
Yeah, it looks
a
fine.
A lot of times we'll either, seems to be something
written write things down,
we'll
or...
either write things down, which, Lillian's taking notes.
Or I'll take
or,
pictures if
we'll
there's
take
a lot
pictures
of information.
If there's something like that. A lot of Light of Our Love episodes.
Scissors.
Plant. Japanese characters appears to be Japanese. If it's another language, I'm sorry. I don't mean any offense. William Pappas. Oh. There have been a number of instances. A to the why
with secret
a with secret previous bitter hate revenge date hoax is from tainted. What? There have been a number of incidents dealing with compromising of secret codes, previous methods. What?
If you read it top to bottom, it says, a bitter hoax tainted with hate is a secret revenge
from a previous date.
Yeah.
Interesting. And that's what the things mean.
Yeah.
Anyway. Hello, Care Interactive. Mystery game. Mystery game.
Okay, that's pretty funny.
And to be fair, they are in Bellevue, Washington. So that's accurate.
Mm-hmm.
And herinteractive.com is still a thing. World's best clear rubber cement, a wonderful adhesive.
Mm.
Why do we keep seeing adhesive everywhere?
Isn't adhesive used for like... Don't quote me on this, but isn't adhesive used for like bombs?
Could be. In some bombs, I would assume.
Castor oil.
Ew. Wait. Were those tainted chocolates just tainted with castor oil?
It's entirely possible.
Because
he ate one and said it was nasty, but he didn't die from it.
Well, and the other thing I'm thinking is, it felt like the note for that one was different than the note from the rest.
Yeah, a little bit.
So I wonder if it's not the same perpetrator for all of them.
I mean, with the way Rick acts, I wouldn't be surprised.
Millie. WWB. 1950? 1958. Yeah. Millie Strashhorn.
Welcome.
Employee ID. Don't know that yet. Floor production list. Not available. Not available. Printing report. There's always printing reports. Finish printing. That's a security report. Can I? There we go. No, I don't need to know how to use the internal system.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We need the
control room? Actor? ACTOR? I'm pretty sure it's that. The rest of them don't seem pertinent to what we've seen so far. Missing prop from Pat Eng. We're trying to locate a beard and mustache ensemble. Wondering if you might have it in your prop room. William Pappas, rating analysis. Randy Hedricks from marketing will sponsor a meeting to discuss last season's ratings and potential strategies. This is the third season in a row where our overall ratings have dropped by unacceptable margins. It's imperative that we meet on this issue to discuss methods of improving our performance. Scripts. Thank you for your script submissions. Okay. Locks. Better control of security codes and locks on the set. I am constantly losing my decoder for the control room lock code. So it is the control room. That verifies that. And Rick Arlen just wants to discuss that. Okay. Where's that printer? Is it this? It is this. Arlen plays receiving those threats, refuses to register complaint with postal authorities. Rick Arlen reports. Receiving anonymous threats, refuses to register complaint. Rick Arlen receives threats, refuses to register complaint. Anonymous threat listing his home address and personal activities at prior night. Mr. Arlen registers complaint with postal authorities. Mr. Arlen receives more threats, registers complaint. So he has been registering complaints. Mr. Arlen receives threatening phone calls on personal cell phone. Rick Arlen registers complaint. Teleprompter sabotage to display death threats against Mr. Arlen, registers complaint. Threatening notes and watch found in Mr. Arlen's dressing room. Mr. Arlen registers complaints. Chocolates tainted with harmless but foul-tasting element found in Mr. Arlen's dressing room. Poorly clamped Klieg light falls on stage. Mr. Arlen registers complaint. Dismantled bomb set up in Mr. Arlen's dressing room. Temporary employee defuses. Government agencies notified for investigation.
So it wasn't until a bomb was put in his room that
authorities were told. Oh, wait. There's the pencil. Excuse me. Suppress a chocolate. Yeah, I'm having a feeling either at least the chocolates are from her.
Yeah.
No. Okay. Moria Cunningham, lunch meeting, call maintenance, extension 231. Reschedule anger support group. And then some code that it just... No.
Yeah.
Does not seem important at this time.
Probably just a venting note.
Probably. Production files backup. Script revisions. Calendar backup. Budget and accounts.
Apparently the ones back there aren't important.
Then why can we look at these ones?
I don't know. I can't take any of them.
There's one, at least, I think there's one that we need in this game.
Is there?
I'm sure it was this game that introduced it.
I need something to make this work.
Oh, so maybe if you look at him now, you could take one.
Or it's in this one.
Oh, that's fair.
Except for I can't look at that one. I can only look at the castor oil in this jar. Okay, then. Wait. How do I loathe thee? That was the one with the chocolates.
That's right. She just took advantage of an opportunity to send him something nasty.
Probably. Okay, can I pick these up now? Doesn't appear to so. Well, that's just that one. Okay. Maybe we'll find it someplace else. I thought it was in here, but I could be wrong. Okay. Is there anything else here? Anger control. Obviously, she has anger issues.
Obviously.
We kind of can get that from... Oh, there you go.
Oh, there it is.
There it is.
Personal files. Yeah, it looks like they were dating.
Yeah, or something.
No wonder she loathes him.
It's like the only time that you use a keyboard on this thing. Rick, you had no right to do that to me last night, and you deserve what you got. How could you just leave me like that with no warning, no discussion? Why am I getting the feeling that I've been used by you? Just like you've used everyone else in this town to get what you want. Now I hear that you're going out to LA for Jocelyn's birthday party. How convenient for you. You used me to meet her, and now you're on her A-list. Do you know how humiliating it will be for me to show up there with everyone knowing about our breakup? You told me we first started dating this, that our relationship was different. Why is this not true anymore? Watch your back, Rick. One of these days, your lies will catch up with you, and you will find there's no one left to use. And don't come to me for any more favors. Once burned, twice shy. Yeah, that's fair. Okay, so we can get access to the control room. I don't know that there's anything else to see in here. So, control room. Use my pass. I literally am holding my pass, Nancy. What's this?
Looks like a bill.
It's a invoice for delivery of something. Which I... Was this here? Yeah, I guess it was. Maybe I just never noticed it somehow. Okay, I assume you've got this figured out.
I do. So...
So that,
mm-hmm.
And then that, and then that, and then that, then that. You are correct. Okay, then. That is a lot of tapes. Okay, there's security tape there. Light reveals what is hidden in the darkness. But you must first unlock the power of the light.
Hmm.
Interesting. Security. No? Okay. Worth a shot. I don't know what to do here, but... Okay.
I need something to make this work.
Yeah, would it be this? Okay, that just turns it off, apparently. Oh, it's because I'm turning up the frequencies, not the channels.
Not the volume.
Didn't you get my first warning?
Somewhere in this room is an explosive device that will blow the air burning sprays.
A lot of background noise. I don't think I need that one.
Lots of street noise.
Lots of street noise wherever this was recorded. I don't hear anything other than that.
Mm-hmm.
I doubt that we can get that so cracked that we could understand it. Sound of something breaking.
The beach?
Something like that.
Doorbell. Thunderstorm.
Stay tuned for Light of Our Love.
No, he means stay tuned for danger.
Alarm clock? Or a phone?
Something. Probably an old phone. Dog.
This has been a presentation of Worldwide Broadcasting.
Okay then, what's this?
I need to find the key for this.
Yes, yes we do. Any keys around?
Doesn't seem like it.
Okay, well, let's go down. We have the thing for the grandfather clock. Do we know what time to set it to? That's the real question. Ew. Don't like that.
It does not like that time, apparently.
I should set the clock.
Was that right? That was right. I literally just guessed. Can I back away now? Okay then. So, is this the one for the lock over here? Yes, yes it is.
Nice.
Pretty sure there's something back here that we can't see that was the thing I was talking about to, like, in the light. Something becomes visible. Pretty sure there's a thing diagram or something there that...
Don't we have to access the light inside the control room or something?
Is that what it is? Does this key also go to that?
I don't know. It would be worth a shot, I guess.
Please
don't. It's locked.
Oh.
That, and then this, and then that, and then that, and then that. Don't make me come back. Please, game. Can we be friends? Yes. Okay, cool. Turn it on.
Cool.
Okay. Is there anything else in here? I don't know that there is. If there is, I'll just have to come back. I just don't want to.
Fair enough.
No. Over here. There it is. Very loud.
Mm-hmm.
What exactly did that do?
Remember what it does, but I don't remember where it does it.
Wasn't it like somewhere on stage?
Yeah, I thought so.
Did we need to leave it on for longer?
Maybe.
Oops. It is for the trapdoor, but...
But where is the trapdoor?
That is a fantastic question that I don't have the answer to. I thought it was, like, behind the couch.
I thought it was, too, but...
But how do... Oh, there we go. There it is. Going down!
Whee! Won't be the last time.
Jollic lift. How they can make it so silent. Worldwide broadcasting
Owen
contractor Owen Spader from Power Stalin.
That same kind of fabric.
There's an employee ID.
Oh yeah, look at that.
2001.
Is that all the missing stuff from the
prop
room?
Some of the missing stuff. There's also beard and mustache missing though. This is a lot of This is a lost and found, so I don't actually know what that's from.
Yeah.
The shirt was definitely missing.
That's right.
Okay.
It's locked.
No dear. Alright, so let's look up that ID on Lillian's computer. Can I? Okay, there we go. No. Back away, Nancy. Back away from the lift. Okay. Can I please escape this?
The torment must continue.
What time is it? 3 a.m.? Okay.
2:15 a.m.
2:15 a.m., you're right. I just took a quick glance. I wasn't actually paying attention to the time.
Fair enough.
So we should still be fine and not get caught, in theory. Can I? There we go. Okay. Millie?
WWB.
1958.
Mm-hmm.
The year she was born?
I honestly couldn't tell you.
Okay, this was not that. Not that. Is it this?
Yes. Yeah.
318-67-2001.
It looks like Owen was on the set every time something happened to Rick.
Interesting.
Dun, dun, dun.
Interesting. I don't know that there's anything else we can do here. Any thoughts of anything that we need to do?
Maybe watch the tape at Maddie's house?
We can go make, watch that at Maddie's.
But other than that, I don't think so.
Hey, taxi!
Where to, lady?
7226 Lexington Avenue, please.
On my way!
Grab the keys.
I'm grabbing the keys. They're just so far down because I only use them once in a while.
Fair enough. Oh, joy.
Hello for Nancy Drew. An alarm clock.
Just to give us a scare.
This is your final warning, Nancy Drew. You better mind your own business and go back to your little life in River Heights. I mean it. Leave town now, or next time you won't be so lucky. That's ominous. Any new notes here? No, just George called. Okay.
Seems a little irresponsible to leave a fire going with nobody here.
Well, she's assumedly she's here.
I need something to make this work. I need something to make this work.
What do you mean?
There we go. Just wasn't clicking the right place. Oh, and Spader. that the talent exit? Can't exactly tell where he's at. That's the same clothing.
Yes, yes, it is.
And that looks like Dwayne. That doesn't bode well.
Nope.
Taxi!
Where can I take you today, miss?
1999 Broadway, please.
Okay. Hello,
can
Ralph.
Can I help you?
Gardino. Yes,
hello.
Here's my pass.
Here's my pass.
Hello, Ms. Drew. Thank you.
You may proceed. Okay. What does Lillian have to say for herself? I was going to use the card, but that would be really
it's
bad.
It's you again. What do you want? Well, can you tell me something about Owen Spader?
No, I can't tell you something about Owen Spader. Why should I? It's none of your business.
Lillian, I have reason to believe you're the one threatening Rick. I know for a fact you sent him those chocolates.
Is that so? Well, I have every reason to kick you off this set. Where do you get off telling me what you think? I'll be calling your agent to let him know we no longer require your services. Get out of my office.
I mean, she didn't take my card.
Nope.
Not this time. I think we've aggravated her, though.
A little bit. She may have deserved it.
It's open.
Maddie.
Have you found anything out yet?
Tell me, do you know someone by the name of Owen Spader?
No, that doesn't ring a bell. Wait, no. No, I'm pretty good at names, but I've never heard of him.
Well, I'll see you later, Maddie.
Be careful, okay, Nancy?
Seems a little suspicious.
Entrevue.
No.
Hello, Miss Drew. I see you can't get enough of me. Do I drive you wild?
Tell me, Rick. Do you know a guy by the name of Owen Spader?
Yeah, I know Owen. He was with the Beekman Theater, wasn't he? Yeah, he's kind of short and stocky. Oh, don't tell me you're seeing him. Don't break my heart, love.
Listen, I gotta go, Rick. Be careful, okay?
Ciao, Bella.
Why Italian all of a sudden?
Because he's gotta show off.
Show off that he knows basically nothing in any language?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what else to do now.
Hey, taxi!
Where to, lady?
7226 Lexington Avenue, please.
On my way!
It's locked.
Dang it. There it is.
Hello?
I don't have much time to explain. Can you meet me at the studio later tonight? I know you won't have any trouble getting in.
I assume that was Lillian.
Lillian, I assume.
Later tonight, so nighttime?
I know you won't have any trouble getting in.
Hmm.
We're in the final act of the game.
Something?
Who do you think it is? Who do you think it
place
is?
Place your bets now.
Where can I take you today, miss?
1999.
This
Broadway
is a spoiler
please.
Warning. If you don't want to know who it is,
stop the
stop
video now.
Code.
3689.
A little dyslexic there.
A little bit.
Okay.
To the studio.
That's
wrong way.
The wrong side. They look the same, okay?
They do.
Especially when they
I see
those...
our Miss Snoop has
hello.
Shown up.
Hello. You kind of scared me.
A little bit.
Why did you ask me to come here?
You see, I've been doing my own investigation, and I kept on finding more and more things until I got a threatening letter yesterday.
Can I see it? Do you still have it?
Thinking of blackmail, my pet? Not if I get to you first. Do you really think you'll find out who I am? And here, I thought you hated Rick as much as I do. But you're still in love with him. You're still sold on his stupid smile and good looks. My puppet, disguised as an actor. That's what he is. A phony. A ladder climber. But he'll fall so far down, no one will ever be able to find him again. I'll push you down too, Lillian. Whatever is in store for Rick will be coming your way as well. So stop playing detective and pretend that this never happened. You'll be much happier and more alive if you did.
The drop
now
wise
do you
again.
Believe me?
Yeah.
Who could
same
be
ones
doing
as him,
this?
As the...
You must know.
Okay. Our options. Lillian. Rick. Dwayne. Maddie. Prop Master, Pappas.
Well, I believe there's only one correct answer
there's
here.
There's only one correct answer. We know that Lillian sent the chocolates.
Yep. I don't think
she did the rest of it.
I don't think Rick did it.
The poem behind the chocolates did not have the dropped Y's and stuff.
Yeah, no.
So I think she was just behind that, and that was just kind of her revenge for breaking up with him. Rick, I don't see why he would do this himself, especially considering that he did report some of the threats.
And he had nothing to gain from it.
Yeah, well, technically you could say that he did if he was trying to break his contract with WWB.
I mean, fair, but just...
Dwayne has obvious bad blood between him and Rick.
And he's in a bad place
right
now.
He's in a bad place. Maddie, like, I don't know. She seems too innocent for that.
Yeah, she does.
Prop Master
is too old.
Well, you never know, but...
I mean, fair.
Yeah, and Pappas... Rick's their biggest star.
Yeah.
Why would Pappas want to be rid of him? Like, yes, we heard that one conversation of, I'll kill him before he leaves. But I still don't think... I think that was just him being Pappas and not...
Yeah, I don't think that was
so
him.
I think Dwayne's the highest suspect.
It has to be Dwayne. Dwayne Powers? But why on earth would he... With his intense hate of Rick, doomed financial situation, and that clever disguise as Owen Spader, Dwayne had every motive and opportunity to commit these threats and traps.
That is correct, Ms. Drew. And now for the bonus round. Name the washed-up director and interfering actress who will be dead in a matter of minutes. Hurry up, contestants. Time's running out.
It's him! Up in the control room! And he's locked us in!
Lillian, hide!
Why, hello, Ms. Drew. I only followed Lillian here, but I've trapped both of you. Your deaths will make a wonderful end to Act One. Rick Arlen's death will be the climax to this little soap opera I've produced. I'm calling it One Death to Die.
Dwayne, why? Why do you hate Rick so much? Maddie and Lillian have more reason to hate him than you do.
More reason than I? Rick Arlen has to die, and I'll tell you why. Because he killed me. He killed Dwayne Powers!
Dwayne, this isn't a soap opera. You're dealing with real people.
Real life is a soap opera. You'll learn that. Or rather, you would have learned that had you lived.
Maddie still cares for you. You're making a big mistake.
Enough! Words, words, words! You will soon see that I am a man of action. I'll come down for the final close-up. I'm gonna write you two out of the script forever! So sorry about your short-lived career, Ms. Drew.
Okay, then.
Places, everyone!
There it is.
Open up in there! Open up!
I hate this. Oh, no. No!
Think, Nancy. Think!
Got it. I failed that one so many times before. The death scenes in these games.
Oh, hello?
Yeah, it's weird.
Time's up! It's curtains for you, Ms. Drew.
It's Ralph!
Ralph!
What's going on in here? Hey,
get him!
Gardino.
This is the guy we've been looking for. Congratulations, Nancy. You've solved the case.
Way to go, Ralph.
Forget about it.
Dwayne's in the right hands now. Case closed. Dear Bess, another mystery solved. Dwayne is now awaiting trial for his attempted murder and has publicly apologized for his crimes. Lillian has moved out to California and is directing her first film. But the best news is about Maddie and Rick. They finally decided to tie the knot. Well, as Serena and Rory. But who knows? Perhaps it'll rub off on them. There's always hope. Love, Nancy.
I don't want to know that I'd want to wish that upon them. Megan Geyser. Well, thoughts?
Well, you know, coming from the other game, it was kind of interesting seeing their first take at like 3D animating people. Yeah. Because they just did 2D animating for the other characters. Mm-hmm.
I think the weirdest part in the first game was the 2D animation in 3D space.
Yeah, it just didn't seem to fit.
In this game, the 3D in a 3D space is okay, but there's kind of this disconnect between animation and what the rest of the world looks almost real life.
Yeah.
And so it still kind of looks a little uncomfortable. But it's definitely better than it was, in all honesty. And I know they just get better from here. But
yeah, they do.
And there's sometimes where just the animations actually look very realistic. one of the ones that kind of made me think of is that that scene right at the end with Ralph. That looks so really rough.
It was rough.
And you can see the green outline around Dwayne.
Yeah.
And it's just like, this is not the way polished. It should be. Wait, Lanny Minella was the voice of Millie Strathorn? That's amusing. Nancy Silhouette Animation. Simon & Schuster. Oh, I guess that makes sense. I think they're the publishers of the books.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Might be. I don't know. I could be wrong. Anyway, yeah. Overall, I think it was decent. I think it was definitely a step in the right direction. Growing up, I had both this game and the first game.
Yeah.
And so, it took me a long time to be able to complete this game. This game was very difficult for me.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I've always liked this series, and so this one and the first game will always have a special place in my heart, just because it's the first ones I ever played.
Yeah,
very early to the series, but then these were the only games I played for a while.
That's fair.
Okay. Let the credits roll, so I guess they don't show
the next
game in this one.
Yeah, that's kind of odd, because they seem to do them for
most games. And they did it for the last, like, the first game.
They did.
So, I don't know. Whatever. Anyway. I don't know exactly what game we're doing next. I don't know that with... I think we're going to do a little bit of breaks, just so people don't get drowned in Nancy Drew content.
Yeah.
Especially if that's not something that you want to see from our channel. It'll probably be, in all honesty, a Lego game next. I was kind of thinking Lego Harry Potter would be fun to jump into.
You know what? That is one of my favorite Lego games, so probably I would be...
Years 1 through 4?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I think that's what we're going to jump into next. We'll jump into, Lego Harry Potter Years 1 through 4, so, we'll see you then.
Bye.
Bye, guys.